Welcome everyone. Again, we are here to discuss upon the second path, which is ecofeminism against power and greed. Through this path, we will learn how male dominated not only the nature, but also the women. And it is not a new thing. It is coming or started from long back, even before the civilization had started. And through various examples, through myth, legends, and other, we will come to know how these points are established and concrete, given a concrete shape by the future generation. And in the line, we are having this very small segment with you. And the picture you can see is this one. That is a small story you all hear or you all been through in your class one or class two, the honest woodcutter whose axe drove into the river and the goddess came with three axes, golden, silver, and iron. And later on, he rejected both the important one and took one with iron, and the goddess pleased and gave him all three axes. And we are given the term honesty is the best policy. But this is one side of the story. Look at the another side of the story, and you are seeing this man, male, as a woodcutter, is cutting iron, cutting these trees with iron. If he has taken that golden axe, it would be impossible for him to cut the tree. He cannot cut tree with the golden one or the silver one. That's why he took that iron one. And since that, you have seen that a man is often cutting the trees. Just remember any tree in your area, who cut it? Is it a man or a woman? You will rarely find a woman cutting a tree. And here something is there for ecofeminist, and this man is the killer of nature. And you can understand it from here. And century established it, man as a killer of nature. And here you can see man have power upon agriculture, pro-recreational activities in which man destroyed the fertility of soil and also exploit women's back. And there are several examples in geography where man is destroying fertility of land through different activities, either by adding more fertilizer or by adding different kind of things, water, soap waters, and so on. In that sense, they are defining or exploiting nature. And since man control the land, they exploit it for their own profit and success. And if you look at the back, hear what this woodcutter is doing. He is cutting nature for his own profit. And this is what ecofeminists are saying. Like either it is nature or women, man is exploiting us for their profit and pleasure. And even some same exploitative pattern of nature is applicable upon women who are exploited either for profit, success, and sometimes for pleasure. That is why you have seen different kind of things. Several women child are killed in the women's belly before their birth by abortion. And against this abortion kind of thing, we are having the famous article or this ecofeminist movement. And in this way, man is seen as the main person behind the exploitation of nature as and women. And that is why in the first slide, in the first part, you have seen that man in a red light, because man is the violent creator of history through ages. Even it is Harappa or whatever war, man is something like this or that. And after establishing man as a killer of nature or killer of women's will, you will find that men never allow women to participate in politics, homemaking, land, farming, or any other business. But after World War II, things change, and now women are having equal opportunity. That is why in the title page, you have seen some white person, because that represents their role in society as a good one as compared to older one. And if you look at the next slide, it speaks a lot. You can identify it. There are several things. Trees are there. Goddess monkey Hanuman is there. Bird is there. Bird parrot is there. And peacock is there. And several other things. But look at those seven or six leaves that are on the feet of Sita Mata. And you will find nature is very clear cut there. And even in her hand, there are some leaves with which man is compared. And this picture speaks a lot. But this is the first part, but what happened after this picture? And that is more important for us. And if you look at the next slide, it speaks a lot. Because after this, Hanumana destroyed Ashok Vatika, but for what? No one knows. And its answer is in perhaps last slides, last one, either for profit, success, or pleasure. And in this slide, you will find Hanumana destroy Ashok Vatika, all trees and so on, and what he get, either pleasure or he want to justify or exhibit his muscle power to Ravan and his people around there. And this is how man also exploits women for no reason, just for pleasure. And to establish his masculine power like Hanumana did, or you could simply say either it is older stories, myth or history. Man exploited nature. Even God cannot save themselves from exploiting nature, and Hanumana was doing this. But let's understand this in a different way. That is a poem, but in Hindi, by one of my students, Sanjana Dubey. And the poem reads, Ram Dut Hanuman Chale Siya Khojne Dekh Lal Sa Khane Ki Maya Lagi Muskane Le Agya Hua Visal Aur Laga Udham Machane संकट मोचन ने योजना सोची क्यों न मापी जाए राक्षस शक्ति राक्षसों की पेड़ लता पल में इधर उधर इतनी अस्थिरता इतनी उथल पुथल राम दूत हनुमान चले सिया खोजने ललकारा लंकेश को कर प्रमाणित शक्ति भई सिया निश्चित तय रावण चिंचित किया युद्ध लंका राक्षसों से नष्ट हो गया वाटिका झट से अशोक था गरुर जिसका किया खंडक हनुमंत उसका राम दूत चल हनुमान चले सिया खोजने. This is a longer portion, but you will find here few things. संकट मोचन ने योजना सोची क्यों ने मापी जाए शक्ति राक्षसों की. These explain like पेड लता पल में इधर उधर. So these things are explaining that man exploit nature either to for pleasure or to show his power. And same happened with that. And in this same way, man exploits women at home. They exploit women for unknown reason. They itself do not know. When man is exploiting nature, they exploit it very badly and they kill everything. And this killing kind of thing can be found in the famous novel by Lewis Carroll. And the novel is Alice in Wonderland. In this, you can find several imaginary creatures and birds. And sometime you will find it, these birds are more like dinosaurs. And even this novel is having a dragon which spit fire, and through it you can understand several things. And the bird in the character Alice you are having is none other than Dodo, and this Dodo bird is very amazing. And if you look at its features, you can compare it with the dinosaurs. And if we look at dinosaurs, the picture is from Google. Most of pictures in this slide or in this presentation are from Google. You have seen different type of dinosaurs, long one, short one, with tails, and different aspects. And even several movies are made on it, but that is not our topic. We are just trying to see the features of these dinosaurs. And if you look at this picture is again from Alice in Wonderland, and you will find that this creature that you can see is the real picture of Dodo bird. This Dodo bird we have seen in Alice in Wonderland, it is reality. In real, it look like, and you can surely compare it with the dinosaurs. It is around 1 meter tall, that is 3.3 feet in length and can be weighed around 10 to 30, 23 kg and having the features of dinosaur. But what happened to this time? This modern dinosaur, or you can say dodo bird, till 16th century or the 17th century, they were on this land, but we killed them because they cannot fly and we eat them. And today they are not found in land. And in one slide, we have seen how many birds are extinct. But if you look at this picture, there is good relation between Alice and bird. So women is having good relations with nature and so on, but man is also seen as a killer of nature. And this killing we can identify in the next slide. Look at this picture, and you all know this. You have seen in several movies or so on, that is amazing Amazon jungle. And 100 years ago, billions of trees were there. But in last 100 years, nearly 50% of Amazon is gone. And today it is dying each year, equal to the different size of birds. And why we are killing them? And simple answer is, and this is why the subtitle or title of the term is greed, because we are killing nature, not for anything, just for greed. We want to comfort, enjoy, and everything. Hence, everything is going and we want pleasure. But for this pleasure, what we are humiliating, either nature or women. So these women and nature are correlated to one another, and without nature cannot exist women, and without women there could be no nature. And just imagine one thing, if you look at women, they take only limited things from nature. If they are working women, they will go to jungle and take the wooden sticks. Those are useless, and they will bring them and cook food. They worship nature and so on. But that is totally opposite in case of male. So male nature means prophet. For women, nature means goddess. And that is why you have seen several god and goddesses, Indians, and women are praised, devoting to trees, and they are worshipping them. Tulsi is also worshipped in India and so on. Several trees you will find women pay their homage to them. Either it is peepal tree, neem tree, these are worshipped. Several temples in India is having these trees and women worship them. So these are the things that women are more connected to nature as compared to men. And this is the theme where we are having. And with this, we end our segment two. And with this, we are having in this section, but we are not going to end. We still having segment three, which also speak about women, nature, and so on. And let's begin the third part about women and ecofeminism